Evening, guys. Dear Lord, I look rough today. I do apologise for my appearance. I'm just about to go into a meeting for Horton Feast, which is our local event held once a year. But obviously, because I'm part of the committee to get the convention off the ground this year, I'd like to keep in the loop, know what's going on, meet a few people, and just generally show my face, really. So yeah, I'm going to do that. Obviously, I'm not going to film that, because it's, you know, it's a meeting. But I'll update you as I come out. And later on, when I go in, I'm going to do some airbrushing and a few models. So I've got a little bit further on the Blade Runner Blaster. And I've got a couple of commissions, so I'm just sorting those out as well. So catch up with me later. Good evening, ladies and gents. I'm back home now after the Horton Feast meeting. Very interesting meeting. First one I've ever been to. Really enjoyed it, really insightful and everything. And I had a really nice chat with Chris, the guy who runs Zaz here in Horton Springs, like dance school, about a couple of ideas I have for the Geek Feast segment that me and Paula are going to do. Well, hopefully going to do anyway. Just a few little ins and outs, technical things, so I don't really know anything when it comes to technical effects and things like that on a stage. And had some really great ideas, and Chris was able to help me possibly realise them. So I'm looking forward to that. Anyway, I'm going to crack on showing you a little bit of piece of how I've getting on with the Blade Runner Blaster since you last saw me. So let's have a look. And as you can see here, this is the top receiver. I've painted it. I struggled with what colour, because you can either have a steel colour or you can have a gunmetal colour. I decided to go with a gunmetal colour because it's darker, and because this kit isn't really particularly very good, it does hide a lot of sins. Now, I went for a chrome sort of colour for the ejector plate here. This isn't glued in yet, because just in case I wasn't happy with this gunmetal colour. But what it was interesting with this gunmetal is when I put it on, rather than just leaving it to dry, I buffed it and rubbed it in certain places, and it gives a really nice effect. I don't know if the camera put it, but it gives a really nice effect into the grain of the resin, and obviously you have the writing, and the darker paint goes into the recesses, and the light of paint is where you've rubbed, and it's come up really nice, really nice metal finish. So I'm quite pleased with that. I think I'll stick with that. I'm quite happy with that. Obviously in here I've left the bare resin, so the glue adheres properly. Here we have the barrel section along with the, I suppose, it's hard to describe what piece this centrepiece is, but it's essentially, this is where the ammo would come out, so this would fold out and the cartridges would go in. This is gloss black, and I've rubbed it down in certain places to obviously show where, but there's three layers of paint in there. So there's a grey primer base, then I sprayed some silver, enamel silver, and then the gloss black went on top. And then I've very lightly, with a very fine sandpaper, gone along the edges to reveal the silver underneath and rubbed it in certain places. Now, I haven't glued or painted in the barrel yet because I need to test fit it. And while test fitting it, I've just realised that this little piece here, which goes there, doesn't fit properly. Now, there's no way really I can make it fit properly. So I'm not really sure what to do. I can, but, you know, just bung it in a little bit and just make it fit with a bit of glue, and hopefully it'll be okay. I'm a bit annoyed about that, because it should just slot straight into that piece there, because there's no other way to make it fit. I'll bodge it and hide it under some weathering. Very annoying. I have some of the little bits and pieces here as well to sort out. That really I should have glued this in before. But if I'd glued it in before, then the barrel wouldn't have gone in properly. So I'm glad I didn't glue it in before. So I'll have to paint this separately, because this is also silver and black. So I'll have to paint that separately and just glue it in there. It's very annoying that it doesn't fit. It really should, because the barrel, obviously, is more important than this little greebly here. So, yeah. Still, never mind. Next up, I have to paint this section here, which goes there, essentially. It's hard to actually put it in. But and then red LEDs go in there. And obviously you have the top receiver, which sits on the top there, like that. That's how it goes on, like that, essentially. And obviously the barrel will be painted the same colour as the top receiver. So then you have the top in gunmetal, the barrel in gunmetal, the barrel chamber in gloss black, and this will also be in gloss black too, and that'll go there like that. So it's, the whole piece, the whole top piece, is going to look like that, which does look strange, but it is a sci-fi gun. But that's how it's essentially going to look, obviously, with this grey bit painted the same as this bit here. And this the same colour as this gloss black. And then I have to start the handle. Now the handle needs a lot more work. In some places it's quite fragile. I'll have to be very careful with it, putting it together. But I'm sure it'll be fine. The grips themselves are going to be a bit of an issue as well. Say all these issues are coming up about this kit. I'm really annoyed. But that's part of the modelling, I suppose. And it's little tricks and tips you pick up. I was hoping to get another couple of pieces here painted today. But I spent longer at the meeting than I planned. This is to go on a box. This is a seal of Rassilon. I'm going to be painting that like a gold brass colour. Very shiny, and obviously some weathering in there. And this is off the Blade Runner blaster. This sits at the back, behind the barrel receiver at the top and the handle. And it's just basically like a spacer to keep everything together and space it out correctly. So there we go. Not a massively exciting day in terms of a vlog, but I've been getting on busy with things, so fortunately that's the way it goes. Things coming up, future. Our next big adventure is London, which is the end of July. That's going to be good. We're going to be, I think it's 3 days in London, and we will be going to Harry Potter again, but I won't film too much there because you remember my epic 3-part vlog of the Harry Potter studio tour. So won't be seeing that. You won't be seeing too much of that. I'll do some things because there is some new things there. The Goblet of Fire is there. It's the first time it's been there since filming. So I'll get that in there. But no, I'll not do a whole massive tour. Because I'll be going to Camden Lock and things like that as well when we go to London. So I'll do a vlog from there. So it'll be interesting. That being said, I will see you tomorrow, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for watching. Really appreciate it. Bye.